All right, so I'm back, and this is that new trailer that I just bought. Well, new used. It needs a couple things done to it, and that's what we're gonna get working on today. First, we're gonna go ahead and cut and put another piece of pressure treat in there, and go from there. So that's a 2x8x8. Obviously, I gotta cut it, make it fit here. I gotta measure it up. Seven and a half. We got 47 and a half. All right. There's an old rusty bolt in here that I gotta get out so that'll fit in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and grind that down. That off. This should fit in there now. All right. So now what we gotta do is I wanna get the holes drilled, put these new bolts and stuff in. See if I can mark them with something. All Well, let me see here. Let's start up top there. Then I can probably flip this thing up once I get a couple screws into it. There we go. Now, this should be be a lot easier. Gotta improvise when you don't have enough screws. Use two nails with a washer and then bend it so it doesn't pop the board out. Two more little lock washers. I'm gonna go grab them. Where'd that other nut go? Ah, that's always fun. Lost one of my nuts. Oh. That's what I did. I put it on the wrong one down here. So, let's check her out. Yep, here we go. Alright, that board's fixed and replaced. Next thing is gonna be this breakaway electric brake box. So let's take a look at this. I got a whole new one to put on. Looks like that just slid on there. Yep. This thing is garbage. Another bolt on the other side holding it, a nut. Thank you. There we go. All right.
This is the old broken junky one. Shove that out of the way. Here's the new one. Ah, perfect. Fits right in there.
The new one mounted up here. That's the wiring. So let's see what we do about the actual electrical now. My new one. You can see, you press the light, comes on green to let you know that it's fully charged. I'm gonna take that mount right off and hopefully this will bolt right on there. Be tougher, it looks like they're, it's been on here for a while. It just looked really rusty. I thought I was gonna have to really pry in the sucker. Alright.
I know something's gonna come up. It's going too easy. There's always something. I don't know. I don't have yellow, but that bolt is going to fit. Yeah. Of course. Got to find some longer bolts.
Longer bolts.
Too thick. All right, those two will work.
or longer. Just gotta search through the bolts. These were all my grandfather's. I saved all this stuff. Because you never know when you need bolts or washers or lock washers or nuts. And got a little bit of everything. Alright, so. This other one in there. Yeah, and this is where everything starts going wrong. Thank you.
one's on there good. Okay, that's on there. This electrical. Thank you. It was at this point that I'm looking at the wires. The wires that were hooked up were not original to the trailer, and they had multicolored wires going through there, so I couldn't really tell which one was ground, neutral, your negative and positive. And this is all done with a voltmeter, which is really simple. And after hooking it up, I was able to find, you know, where my power was and where, which one was my ground and everything. And was able to hook the three wires up. It's pretty simple, but since the battery electric brake wires were blue, black, and white, you know, you gotta go through the instructions to make sure you find out which one's your power. Normally they'll have like red for power, black for your ground, and then white will be your neutral, but everything is different.
See the instructions,
so
see
that's why
here.
You gotta look through the instructions. And after I did that, I went ahead and hooked the three wires up, and it was all set and ready to go.